Hello, I'm David Hughes. Welcome to Your Perfect Body, the podcast of the Esoteric Teaching Community. Today's selection is an essay entitled Dimensions of Ontology. The last couple of days, we've been speaking about the three levels or phases of realization of the esoteric teaching: Bhagavan, or the impersonal effulgence of God; Paramatma, or the indwelling Supersoul, witness and friend in the heart; and Bhagavan, or the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There's a nice verse from the esoteric teaching: vadanti tattva-vidas tattvam jnanam advayam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavan iti sabdyate. Learned transcendentalists who know the absolute truth call this non-dual substance Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. That's from Srimad Bhagavatam 1.2.11. All three levels of realization are simply different views of the same non-dual transcendental object, namely the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But only the Bhagavan-realized devotees see him as he is. Others have only partial realization depending on their consciousness. Remember from our discussion of ontology that the quality of our ontology determines our consciousness? An ontology, in this sense, is a large collection of stories, facts, and observations about how the world works. Everyone has an ontology, but our ontology can be of greater or lesser quality, depending on the sources of information we use to compile our stories about the world. So now we can understand that the quality of our ontology determines how we experience God. A person with a materialistic ontology sees God as death, or at best, as a supplier of material benefits. This is a zero-dimensional view of God, and we can compare it to a point. A person with Brahman realization sees God as the all-pervading impersonal spiritual effulgence. We can compare Brahman realization with a line, an object of one dimension. A person with Paramatma realization sees God as the Supersoul dwelling within his heart. This level of realization can be compared with a plane, or two dimensions. And a person with Bhagavan realization sees God as Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is three-dimensional, or complete, realization of God. Now, what is the advantage to having a three-dimensional spiritual ontology, as compared with a one- or two-dimensional spiritual ontology, or a zero-dimensional material ontology? There must be some benefit, or the esoteric teaching would not recommend so highly that we should strive for such a high degree of realization. Bhagavad Gita says, Shruti vipratipanna te yada shasyati nishchala samadhav achala buddhis tada yogam avapsyasi. When your mind is no longer disturbed by the flowery language of the Vedas, and when it remains fixed in the trance of self-realization, then you will have attained the divine consciousness. Bhagavad Gita 2.53. The trance of self-realization means samadhi. Samadhi means that one has fully realized Bhagavan, or Krishna consciousness. That is, one in full samadhi has realized Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. The highest perfection of self-realization is to understand that I am eternally the servitor of Krishna, and my only business is to perform spiritual service in Krishna consciousness. This state of consciousness, called samadhi, is the complete cessation of all material suffering. As it is stated in Bhagavad Gita, the stage of perfection is called trance or samadhi. In that blissful state, one's mind is completely restrained from material mental activities by practice of yoga. This perfection is characterized by one's ability to see the self by the pure mind and to relish and rejoice in the self. In that joyous state, one is situated in boundless transcendental happiness, realized through transcendental senses. Established thus, one never departs from the truth, and upon gaining this, he thinks there is no greater gain. Being situated in such a position, one is never shaken, even in the midst of greatest difficulty. This, indeed, is actual freedom from all miseries arising from material contact. Bhagavad Gita 6:20-23. From ordinary material consciousness to the perfection of Krishna conscious samadhi is a long road indeed. When a person enters into the study of the esoteric teaching to obtain vidya, spiritual knowledge, he begins to follow the moral strictures of human civilization. Then, becoming purified to some degree, he advances further to study the Upanishads and gain brahma-jnana, impersonal realization of the absolute truth, or Brahman realization. Then he advances still further to Sankhya Yoga to understand the Supreme Controller, who is indicated in Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna uvacha parang brahma parang dhamma pavitrang paramang bhavan purusham sashvatam divyam adidevam ajam vibhum. Arjuna said, "You are the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the ultimate abode, the purest, the absolute truth. You are the eternal, transcendental, original person, the unborn, the greatest." Bhagavad Gita 10:12. When one understands the Purusha, the original person and supreme controller, to be Paramatma, the Supersoul, one is engaged in the real Vedic method of yoga. Dhyana vashtita tadgatena manasa pasyanti yang yogino yasyantam navidu surasura gana devaya tasmai namaha. I offer my humble obeisances unto that Supreme Personality of Godhead, whom the perfected yogis see within their minds after fixing themselves in trance and absorbing themselves within him, and whose limit can never be found by any demigod or demon. Srimad Bhagavatam 12:13:1. As we have quoted several times, the absolute truth is realized in three features, brahmeti, paramatmeti, bhagavan iti sabdyate. Each level of realization reveals an additional ontological dimension to the consciousness of the devotee, until one is able to see the original Supreme Personality of Godhead face to face. This is the perfection of self-realization and the beginning of the trance of samadhi, which annihilates all material miseries. This is the real aim of this esoteric teaching. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayana, instructed Brahma, the first created being in the material universe, in this esoteric teaching, whose narrations produce detachment from material consciousness, and which contains the essence of all Vedanta philosophy. Among all the Vedic scriptures and all the religious philosophies of the world, the esoteric teaching of Srimad Bhagavatam is the best and most complete. It is the dearmost possession of the Vaishnavas, those who worship, serve, and adore the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The esoteric teaching reveals that spotless, supreme knowledge accessible only to the Paramahansas, and it also reveals the confidential yogic process by which one can become free from the karmic reactions of material work, a process enriched with knowledge, renunciation, and devotion. This esoteric teaching